My dear friends, students, okay. First up, let me introduce myself. My name is Kishor Sankhe. I have graduated from Mumbai University and joined in Mahindra as a graduate engineer training. Okay. And you know, M&M is a big group. And as a graduate engineer, I joined in 1992 and 2018. That means I have completed 26 years service in Mahindra Mahindra. So it's a very long tenure. And in long this tenure, I have worked in various departments. I have started my career in the shop floor, that is in manufacturing. Then I have implemented lot many world-class manufacturing techniques in the manufacturing, like Toyota production system. Then most as an industrial engineering techniques. Then lot of quality, what quality systems. Then TPM, total production maintenance. And there onwards, then after working for 8 years in the manufacturing, I moved to vendor development and purchasing role for last my almost 16 years. Okay, and this career I have interacted with all the departments of Mahindra Mahindra. So today I would like to tell you what a typical big OEM or any company will expect from the graduate engineer. So let us start from the vehicle point of view. Typical any vehicle will consist of 1000 plus parts, okay, and then vehicle is made, and then vehicle is made from the market perspective. Okay, for example, recently we have launched Marazzo as a vehicle, correct? And if you see the Marazzo vehicle, where do we want to place in the marketplace? So it is almost like a Innova looking vehicle or better than Ertiga like vehicle. So this kind of vehicle should be sold at what price in the market or at what price customer will buy it. So that as an engineers we have to keep in mind. Okay, and then that is how the typical company will start approaching for a vehicle. So this and then we decide what is the selling price for the vehicle, and then we also know the what should be the cost, manufacturing cost or process cost or R&D cost for this product, and then we decide the cost for that product. Then typically all the departments like R&D, process engineering, manufacturing engineering, quality engineering get a target ki this ye part ye target mein banana hai. Okay. So the most vital function in this is at the design level. Okay. So this is called the concept called design to cost. Okay. So for each vehicle, each system of the vehicle, as I told you, the 1000 parts. So each part becomes very important from the design point of view to decide that how this part should be designed for the cost. Okay. For example, if you talk of one product like say oil pan cover. Okay, so oil pan cover, suppose the target is given to the engineer, say it should be made in say 200 rupees. Then to make part in 200 rupees, how my design should be? Okay, design cannot be so complex. Okay, then you should know the what material should be used for that pan, whether it should be rubber material, whether it should be a plastic material, it should be sheet metal, whether it should be casting, which should be forging or aluminium. So various this thing. So cost comes from the selection of the material, also the how the geometry of the part, how the part will be manufactured a very cost effective manner. All this parameter has to be thought by the designer, and then there where your CAD skill comes into picture, CAE comes into picture. You must be knowing CAE. Then you should not be over designing the part. Okay, you should optimize design so that you can always maintain the cost under control. Okay, and you should also know the how the part is going to perform in the field side, correct? If I design a part, it should not go in the field and the fail. So you should also know the where the part is fitted, what is the function of the part, how the part is going to behave in the field. Okay, whether the part is manufacturable, whether the part is measurable, all these parameter any design, engineers has to keep in the mind. So after designing a part, okay, then it comes to process engineering, the how part should be developed or how the part should be made, correct? So when it comes, then process planning part comes into picture, that how part should be made in terms of what are the process I should be selected, whether it should be casting, whether it should be forging. After casting, forging, then which machining it will take, it should be turning, it should be grinding, it should be done on the VMC or it should be done on HMC. And to decide this, the most important element of the what we get taught in the engineering is the GD&T comes into picture. So GD&T becomes the very, very important parameter for process engineering, for manufacturing people and quality people, because R&D has given some specific dimension tolerancing on the what in the drawing to take care of the end customer requirement. And to meet that end customer, I need to design a right process, okay? I have to select the right machines, I have to select right fixtures, I have to also do the right gauging, measuring system, okay, CMM. So that all comes into picture when it comes to manufacturing and development process. And when it comes to quality, quality people is very important in terms of how to give the right process in assurance manner, where the rework rejections become very important point, which how to control the ongoing processes. Okay. And then if you heard the a concept called PPM, parts per million, correct? So this also very important. Currently world is very stringent when it comes to rework and rejection. We have to operate with minimum rework rejections. Current targets worldwide for PPM is only single digit, that maximum 10 PPM is accepted. 10 PPM is only 10 parts are allowed to get rejected when I produce 1 million part. That is, in 10 lakhs part, only 10 parts should be rejection is allowed. So when I do that, that means my I am keeping my cost under control and I am not passing on any rework or rejection part to the end customer. So end customer is also assured in terms of when he buys the vehicle, because any end customer, when he buys the vehicle, he expects his vehicle should not going to break down for at least 3 to 5 years, or 3 lakh kilometers to 5 lakh kilometers. That is what the industry expectation from the all the departments like design, process engineering, manufacturing engineering, quality engineering. That's from your point of view or industry point of view. Also, one point I would like to tell, that whatever the department you go, it should be your area of liking, you should be passionate about that. You should be always, your mind should be always curious where this part is getting used, how this part can be made in better way, how design can be better. You should be always on the improvement path. How I am going to make my design better, how I am going to make my process better, how I am going to check it better. So always your mind should be tuned for the continuous improvement as a design engineer. That is what the industry will always expect. Okay, other than that, anything if I missed out, maybe when I do the design, I have not covered on the one of the how the designers get validated. So when I do the design, when I do CAE, I generally put that part, make the part to start with, just we call the concept modeling, that generally use the RPT as a technology. RPT is a rapid prototyping. Okay, there you get a what broad image, how 3D image will look like, and generally you get a clear picture how the part is look like and whether the part is going to fit or not, or whether it will be able to package that in the vehicle design or not. That is where it comes into very handy. And generally RPT you make through 3D printing machine, which generally nowadays all college start teaching in the college. And after RPT, then you go into finer CAE elements, and then when your design is ready, concept design, you put in the rig testing in this thing. Then you do the rig testing and you get your design verification. Then you put in the field and to get the early alarm from the field side. That is more detailed from the design part of it. But today's my message was to generally tell you that how each and every department is very important. No department is inferior. Okay, R&D is equally important, process engineering is equally important, the design, part development is also important, supplier quality is important, manufacturing quality is important, quality engineering is important. All departments play a very vital role, to meet the end customer. And what end customer require, or companies are basically three parameters. It is a quality, cost and delivery. So quality should be always improved day by day, and our mind should be always turned ki how I am going to give better and better quality to the end customer, India or export. Generally, India currently is not known worldwide for giving the better quality. So onus lies on us as an Indian to how to compete with the world's best. Who is the world's best? Japanese is like world's best. Germans are best. US are best. So when people start giving us more and more job in the India, so onus lies with us as an Indian supplier base, Indian manufacturer, how do I give the better quality? So when that onus lies on India, so onus lies on you, new generation, how you are going to have the commitment to give the right quality, consistent quality, how to operate PPM below 10. Okay, then becomes, you should not, then to achieve that, what quality, you cannot go on what increasing your cost. Their cost comes into picture. My cost also has to be optimum. In that process, I cannot become costlier than US, German or Japanese. So I have to maintain the cost control. Then other instrument like automation, low cost automations come into picture. Okay. And then when it comes to design, as I already told, DTC, design to cost, becomes very important. So cost I covered, quality I covered, and delivery should be always consistent, no delivery should be default. And then because once you default the delivery, then OEMs are not able to make the vehicle, then end customers doesn't get the vehicle in time, and then he can go to other competition for you. To maintain your market share, then your delivery becomes the very important. Okay, so this is my side from Mahindra. Thank you very much.